Alright, here we are on the draw for round one. I think this is definitely a keeper. We have turn one Delver, and then turn three Seagate Oracle, and any filter lets us cast our Cryptic. Ooh, Stromkirk Noble. That could be trouble. Okay. Well, unfortunately our hand is actually all humans. Jeez. That is a beatdown. So we might have to use our Cryptic to bounce that shrine at some point. Fortunately we have like the Thrag Tusk angle in our deck, which could be good. We're also completely dead to the Armageddon that we passed in this draft, which is a little bit awkward. Alright, I have a feeling our Delver is not long for this world. I think I want to play the Coalition Relic here. That way if he does like try to Armageddon or something, we can cast Seagate Oracle next turn and try to claw back into things. And also that way it just sets us up to cast Tidings next turn, which is going to be very good. The window is also kind of closing on us to deal with this Stromkirk Noble. We don't have a lot of removal spells that kill it outright, because they mostly deal 2 or 4 damage or so. Hopefully he doesn't have anything here. Figure of Destiny. Okay. Charge this thing. I think I'm just going to go ahead and cast Tidings this turn. The other option is to cast Huntmaster. Actually, Huntmaster is going to be better, I think. Yeah, if we cast Huntmaster, we can chump block Stromkirk Noble, and if he, like, goes all in on just pumping Figure, then it'll flip, and that'll be good, because then we'll be able to block Stromkirk with it. I think I like this. Oh, he didn't even level Figure. That's kind of interesting. I wonder why he did that. That makes me think he might have the Boros Charm we passed, and he might be holding that up right now. Not totally sure. Alright, well, definitely chump blocking this thing. Don't really want to just die. Now he levels the Figure. Very perplexing. Alright, man down. Charge this bad boy up. Let's empty for blue. And we could cast. I think pretty much no matter what happens this turn, we're casting Seagate Oracle, so I think we'll start there. And then we could, like, Cryptic the Shrine if we need to. I think that is what we're going to need to do. Maybe playing Serendib is okay. And continue to try to draw out to Wildfire or something. Because if we play Serendib, we can like chump block Stromkirk, chump block Figure, and then if we draw Wormcoil, or I'm basically just trying to keep this Stromkirk Noble a little bit under control. The other option is like tap his guys and bounce Shrine, although that does give him the option to shoot it at us. Yeah, I think I'm going to pass and try and either counter a spell in Bound Shrine or tap his guys in Bound Shrine. Although tapping his guys in Bouncing Shrine actually doesn't work now that I think of it because of the way Cryptic Command works. Alright, so he's just going to level. So I'm going to tap his guys and bounce Shrine. And then next turn we can just cast Tidings and hopefully find our way out from there. We could also draw Mizzium Mortars at this point, which would be insane. Can't use that. Alright. Tidings. Right, there's our Mizzium Mortars. I think I'm just going to kill Stromkirk Noble now. And then we'll find a way to deal with Figure of Destiny later. I'm not going to chump it, though. Well, I might have to chump it. No, I'm not going to chump it this turn. I'm probably going to trade, like, Serendib plus Electrolyze for it or something like that. It's going to replay Shrine and a 2-1. Okay, well, that at least doesn't affect us in particular. So let's start things off with Ponder, certainly. Ooh, Thragtusk. Yeah, that's pretty good. So we can draw the Thragtusk and shuffle away the other two. I like that. I think I'm going to find Underground Sea and cast Serum Visions this turn. Rolling Earthquake. Alright, that's pretty good. I think I don't really need Essence Scatter. I think between Rolling Earthquake, Electrolyze, we have enough ways to kill other creatures. So I'm going to keep the Izzet Charm and ditch the other one. The Izzet Charm should basically be as good as a counterspell, because it can kill any creature I can imagine him casting for this mana, and it can counter any spell, because he's pretty mana screwed at this point. Alternately, it can double up with Electrolyze to kill Figure of Destiny if we end up needing that. I will definitely block. He might have Boros Charm to save his guy, but that's fine if he does. Nope, we're just going to trade. Alright, I feel pretty good about where we are at this point in the game now. Charge up our Co-Relic. I'll empty for blue and cast Serendib right here. And then we can actually attack with both of our guys. And there's not a lot he can do because we have so much counter magic at this point. There aren't a lot of, I guess he could have like Resto, but there aren't a lot of other red-white creatures that really get us here. I wonder if he has the Siege Game Commander that was in the draft. Wouldn't be that big a deal. I think we could just Rolling Earthquake for two. Kill all the things. Alright, a morph that I'm going to guess is Blistering Firecat, but could also be Gathan Raiders, I suppose. Co-Relic. So we can Rolling Earthquake for enough to kill him if he doesn't block. I'm going to leave the Seagate Oracle back just because it doesn't really do anything to attack with it. Alright, he's going to take 6. Yeah, we should be able to, we can cast Rolling Earthquake with, like, negate backup. Or no, not quite. Just cast it for 7, should be fine. Can't think of a lot of red spells that deal with this. Alright, so it was Blistering Firecat. Good to know. I think Forkbolt is going to be good. He had a lot of 1-drops that we would be interested in killing. And Spell Pierce, I think, on the play is going to be better than... or on the draw is going to be better than Negate. Just because I'll want to counter Shrine. If he has, like, turn... if we don't have a turn 1 play and he has turn 1 Shrine, I want to be able to counter it. I think Time Warp is probably the most board outable card here. All of our other cards seem okay. Essence Scatter might also be a little meh.